Hello friends, welcome to Radio Karishma, welcome to Kuch Khush Baatein with your favorite RJ Khushboo Rawlley. Today we have with us a super inspiring personality, Mr. K.Y. Venkatesh. He stands 4 feet and 2 inches tall, but his short stature could not stop him from accomplishing any of his dreams. He is in Limca Book of Awards for representing India in 2005 World Dwarf Games. At that time, he won 6 medals in the games, 2 gold, 1 silver and 3 bronze in athletics and badminton games. He is also a secretary of Dwarf Sports Association of India. So friends, let's welcome to the show Mr. Venkatesh. Mr. Venkatesh, welcome. First of all, we would like to know, how did you get into this world of sports? What was your inspiration?
Hi, I'm Venkatesh. I'm based in Bangalore, South India. Actually, I am the youngest in my family. I have 4 sisters and 1 elder brother. I started my sports seeing the activities of C.N. Janaki, who is a paraplegic, polio affected. She crossed the English Channel. That was the inspiration I got, and then I started my sports in the year 1994. I represented my country in the IPC World Championship at Berlin, Germany.
Wow, when you represented yourself in Berlin, which sport were you playing at that time?
At that time I was participating in athletics, that is shot put and discus.
Awesome. So as a child, were you interested in sports ever since?
Yes, I was sport from during my childhood only. I started my game called chess. My father is the real coach. Here they have come with a special edition, the disability edition. In that they have identified 15 people. They are giving an award as People of the Year award. People of the Year throughout India. In that I have also been selected as a Limca People of the Year for the year 2016.
Wow.
That is a big award. It's like that is equivalent to a national award. National award.
Wow.
Because till now I have not got any national award. That is my first pillar award, I can say.
That is truly amazing. Truly, truly amazing. Congratulations. Oh gosh, we are so proud of you. Keep up the good work.
That's Limca Book of the Year. You can view in the link. You can see People of the Year 2016. Around 15 people are there. In that, I am on one of them. And this function will be held on April 14th in New Delhi. The Honorable Prime Minister might be giving this award.
Wow, forward to all that news, which is truly, truly amazing, and many, many congratulations to you. I'm sure your parents have been quite supportive and have promoted you in all the games that you wanted to play.
Yes, because seeing my this one, they thought something he might do, but they didn't expect so much I will do to, and so much name will come to my family as well as to our country. They didn't expect that much I will grow. I'm not in height, but in my achievement.
But that's actually more important. Achievements are absolutely more important. But still, having a supportive family and getting the right opportunities, but still, the efforts were yours. So how much practice have you done? It seems you are into a lot of games, badminton, throw put, shot put. So I wonder how many hours do you put in a day to towards games?
See, actually, I thought this will be my recreation, I thought, and I started the other games also for my fitness. For that game, it became a real game, lucky this one. I could participate in my international also. But usually, I used to spend, believe it or not, only 2 to 3 hours, my practice was.
That's really amazing. So, you started representing India in 94. And you have come a long way. You are currently Secretary of Dwarf Association in India. So would you like to talk more about your role in that association?
Yes. That is what I wanted to bring about, get the awareness. As you are aware, these dwarf people are not much into sports. They might go for the other, this one, because they don't, in India, their awareness is zero, I have to say. So I was the first person to represent the first Dwarf Games in 2005 at the France Ramboy. Mm-hmm. So from there I came back I've started an organization called Dwarf Sports Association of India. I got it recognized at the International Dwarf Sports Association, UK. Then I put spread this awareness through the electronic, print media, digital media, everything. And we went in the year 2009. I took a team of around 8 people to Northern Ireland, Belfast. There, the around 9 people also won the medal. Our country's was in the 4th position, to say.
That's awesome. So the participants in your association, are they based out of Bengaluru or different places?
They're spread. Yeah, they're spread all over India. Most of them are in the South India. So it is comfortable. It is easy for them to access. But now this year, next year, 2017, we have a World Dwarf Games in Canada. So we are planning to get a huge team to go to Canada. So in the month of August or September, I'm planning to hold a national games. National games, all games like athletics, badminton, swimming, table tennis, all and boccia. All these events, and this will be the selection trials for the World Dwarf Games.
That's amazing. Like you yourself have won so many medals. What do you think about media, the regular primetime media, promoting this sector of games? Of course, we pay a lot of attention to cricket, for sure. I mean, I myself love it. But at the same time, there are so many other things happening in India, I think, which are equally important. So what do you have to say on that?
See, media is the key player, I have to say. Media is the pillar. Without media, our awareness or it would have not spread so much. As you are aware, see, my message has gone to all parts of the world.
Absolutely.
So like this, the media is the key. It is the key, I have to say, for the log. They have done an excellent job. Though the other sports are there, they are covering equally. But some part, they are giving preference. But also, they are encouraging. Like this, it's like two sides of a coin, I have to say. The media is doing two sides of the coin. They are not too partial to one game or the other. Mm-hmm. But they are concentrating on others also. Now in India, this kabaddi has started. Mm-hmm. So that's also holding a key player. Like that, even our para, it will be... So now it's initial. After a few years, it will also get a big name, I can say.
So well said. It's like two sides of the same coin. Media has its responsibilities and it has its own restrictions also. But really nice that things are actually coming in the limelight, which need attention, which need due attention.
Yes.
So I would like to know, what is your experience, like you have represented India internationally. What is your experience in terms of the problems that people face, or especially the dwarf people face in their sector of games? Are they taken care of well enough? Where do we lack in terms of representing India? All that.
See, actually in India, major the constraint is for them the finance, the sponsor thing. These people now, actually the government is yet to recognize our dwarf sports. It is not yet still included in the para sports, which is comes in the para. The Paralympic, this one. But in the other countries, the Paralympics, it has been included. In Paralympics also, we have an event, only field event, that is called shot put, discus, javelin. No other events is there in Paralympics. So, like that, in our government of India has to come forward, has to identify us, recognize us, and they have to be the backbone for us to encourage and to support our dwarf people, I have to say.
That is actually so well said, and actually very important also. Of course, why not? They are playing the same game. Why not recognize them equally? Yeah, we have all the different kinds of sectors anyways, like under 15, under 10, whatnot. So we are recognizing them, you know, at their own level. So why not this? All the best. I hope something gets done over there.
Only one thing I wanted to miss.
Go ahead.
See, actually, in our we are based in Karnataka, that is Bangalore. In the Bangalore, we have an area called Malleshwaram. our local MA elected representative, Dr. Ashwath Narayan, who is an instrumental, actually is a politician. He doesn't have much knowledge on para sports. When I started conducting national badminton tournament, I invited him and I showed him all the talents, how they are and how they are equal in normal with normal. So he started promoting para events, and he, wherever he has done a grounds or the infrastructure facility, all are user friendly. Even the gym or the swimming pool or the athletics, whatever you say, you name it, it should be user friendly. Like that, I request all the in our India, all the politicians to come forward to support and encourage for the development of our para sports. And one more lady by name Padmini, who had come all the way from US for our nationals for the support and development of our para sports, which is called as adaptive sports, we call it. She is also instrumental in coming forward, and I request all the philanthropists to support and encourage us, I have to say.
That was very good to hear that MLA from your area is actually helping you out and helping to create, make India a user-friendly place for dwarf people. We all know that India has a long way to go in terms of providing infrastructure that helps everybody. But one step at a time is whatever is being done. It's truly, truly recommendable. This is happening in patches. What else in general would you want to happen in India to make India more user-friendly?
See, not only for our dwarf, for all the wheelchair-bound or the paraplegic. These are the major people in our para. These people, they don't feel the pain when they fall or when they do athletics. For them, you have the user-friendly like ramps in multi malls. You go to malls or a corporation building, huge function, wherever it is. Please provide them the user-friendly wheelchair access like bus stop, railway station, everything. I request all the, not only the government, even the private people to come forward to support and encourage us, I have to say.
Absolutely, absolutely. So, what are any upcoming events that you have? I know you organize annual badminton talent competitions. And what are your other kind of plans to get such talent towards your association?
See, this now I told you on the month of August or September, the date is not yet finalized. I will be conducting the National Dwarf Games. Mm-hmm. All the events will be there, I said, as like athletics, badminton, table tennis, swimming. All these events will be there. This will be the selection trials for the 2017 World Dwarf Games in Canada. Mm-hmm. So I request all the philanthropists to come and support me and make this event a grand success. It will be held in Bangalore.
Okay, awesome. I would like to say the same on your behalf, that we must support your association. It really needs genuine backing, and we are absolutely proud that there are people who are not stopping and still going out there and working so hard, and they are representing India at such great level, and you especially have won so many medals, and I'm sure there's a lot of hidden talent which yet needs a stage.
Yes.
Is there any other such association in India which works in this area?
See, not associations, there are many organizations, they are coming forward, I have to say. There are many organizations. Sports organization, we have different sports organization in para. Like swimming, para swimming is there. Para weightlifting is there. Para athletics is there. Para table tennis is there. Para badminton is there. And para equestrian is there. Like that's all the para Olympic event which all are there. We have a para federations, we call it as. We have that.
Okay, sounds good. So how tough is this for a dwarf person to get into the games and to be a part of competition if, let's say, they're not in Bangalore, they're somewhere else, though they might not know your association yet. Just in general, how tough is it to be a part of such competitions, and what needs to be done there?
Khushboo, I want to tell you one incident. Mm-hmm. In the year 2009, we have a event. One person was there from rural part of Karnataka.
Mm-hmm.
He's a dwarf. He's mm-hmm. a farmer.
Oh.
He's a farmer. And he doesn't know to read English or Kannada.
Oh.
He came to know our that we are, have a sports, we are doing that. So he started practicing in his field only, the athletics, because we have to have it in the track. The events, running event should be held in track. But he started practicing in his paddy field. Then he came to our 2009 World Dwarf Games in Northern Ireland. He won gold in 50 meters, 100 meters, 200 meters. Believe it?
Wow, this is amazing. See, this is like,
so,
you know, if
like
you have
that,
dreams, just, you know, throw it out in universe. Somewhere, somehow you'll get connected and find that space and just don't give up, basically.
Yes, my punchline is, give us an opportunity, we will show what we are. Only we need an opportunity.
That is so amazing, so true. That is so well said and so true for everybody. Everybody is waiting for some or other opportunity, and why not? And everybody deserves it. And you equally deserve it. You are really working hard towards it. So we really wish you all the best.
Yeah. See, his name is Devappa More, that farmer. And I have one more person by name Biju. He is in Kerala, south part of India, Kerala.
Mm-hmm.
He also doesn't have the knowledge, but he also came to know he is a badminton, good badminton player. He plays so much. He could, in the world championship also, he has came up to semi-final. So this is the thing that get the message gets spread. Though if media is also not there, the message is spreading. So they are all coming forward, I can say.
That's awesome. Yes, if you really work hard, you definitely show up eventually, and eventually world has to give you attention. So, and
correct.
It seems you all are so out there and perseverant towards what you're doing. So, of course, success would come to you one day.
Thank you.
So, Venkatesh, would you like to talk about your dreams, aspirations for your future?
See, actually, my major dream was to win the medals and bring laurels. My other dream is to visit US, Canada and New Zealand, because I visited all the countries. But major, I want to see US, Canada and New Zealand. This is the major dream. If an opportunity comes, my dreams will be fulfilled.
Oh, absolutely. We wish you all the best. And of course, you have visited so many countries. You have represented India in so many countries. We do want you to come to US and Canada and New Zealand. We want all your dreams to come true. And why not? So what are your hobbies?
Thank you. Have a nice... See, my major hobby is browsing net, for social network, and chatting with all the people, and spreading our sports, para sports, to all this in the social media.
Sounds good. And we would like to know one more thing before we leave. What is your favorite song? Since this is Radio Karishma, we would love to play that after this interview.
Mera naam Joker, jeena yaha, marna yaha, Raj Kapoor.
Wow, that's an amazing song. Would you like to sing? This is, you sing well, it seems.
Jeena yaha, marna yaha, Riste Shiva.
Thank you.
A little bit, that's all.
Thank you so much, Venkatesh. It was truly an honor to talk to you. Thank you for giving us your precious time, and see you soon.
Radio Karishma, to give an opportunity all the way calling from US to India. So I should say thanks for your this one, and you are spreading our message. You are doing a great job. A big salute and a hats off to you people.
Thank you so much. You're most welcome. Honestly, we are honored if we could help you out in any which way. This is the medium that we have, and we hope you get support from all the other mediums that you wish for, and all the best in your efforts. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Bye-bye. Anything that you want to say to our audience?
So, only the audience, I say, we the dwarf people of India are very capable of doing this. So, please, I request all of you to support and encourage. That is, I want encouragement we require in India. If you do give us an encouragement, we can also prove how the other countries win medals. We can also show you we can also win medals. That is what only I want.
That's awesome. So well said, and I'm sure our audience will support you and follow you and help you in whichever way they can.
Thank you so much,
Venkatesh, for talking to us. It was truly amazing and truly inspiring, and I'm sure our audience truly, truly loved your spirit. Thank you for coming on the show for Radio Karishma.
Thank you very much.
So friends, you were listening to Venkatesh Yethiraj. Hum aise hi aapke samne aate rahenge ek isi tarike ki inspiring personalities ko leke hamare har next episode mein. Stay happy, keep smiling and keep listening Radio Karishma. Thank you. See you next time.